don't know what it's about. Like, I mean, Einstein hated it. He just, it turns out everything he thought about quantum mechanics turned out to be wrong. He thought it was incomplete, but he had it right in his heart. It's just weird, and there's no understanding. I mean, that's my opinion. And yes, I talk about this subject all the time to the public, and I can describe quantum mechanics to my grandmother. It has two rules, and there's no math. The two rules are that quantum things can be in these funny states of superposition. The bit we mentioned before, 0, 1, a quantum bit can be 0 and 1 at the same time because it's a wave theory. There are many wave theories we find in nature, sound waves, water waves. When you play two notes on the piano, your ear perceives both notes at the same time. And you can think of that as deriving from the wave properties of the complex wave that hits your ear. You hear both notes. That's rule number one. And by itself, it's not revolutionary, not incredibly interesting, really. It's a wave theory. The math can get arbitrarily complicated there. And people tend to get, when quantum mechanics is taught in universities, it's taught from that perspective. You go through the math of solving the wave equation. But look, I mean, the wave equation for water waves is just as complicated. And by going through more and more math, you're not going to really understand too much more about waves. We all know that at the beach, the waves, you know, they grow and then they turn over and they crash. Very complex mathematics describing that. But there's no more understanding of what's going to happen. So this brings me to rule number two, which is really the bizarre thing. Rule number one says that you can have these fuzzy states. Things can be in two states. This cup can be in two places at the same time. That's what quantum mechanics says. If it's a wave, it has, you know, it has a funny wave here and there. Rule number two, though, it says that rule number one only works when you're not looking. That's it. And when you do look, it pops into one or the other randomly. Okay, so those are the two rules. You take them or leave them. There's no understanding. They're exclusive rules. You can't derive one from the other. In physics, we hate that. Einstein wanted, you know, one law to describe everything, and he couldn't do it. He failed doing that. Nobody has really unified those two rules, so we live with it. And those are layman's rules. They're rules that that's how I think of quantum mechanics. So there doesn't have to be any math. It's just super weird because it involves, when you look at such a superposition of two states, it changes it just by looking at it. And so there are many ways to cast what's weird about quantum mechanics. One way is to say that the observer plays a special role. That's the only theory of all of nature where the act of observing changes the system itself. So some people have gone off the deep end and thought about consciousness and how, you know, there must be quantum mechanics in the brain. I don't know what to say about that. That's just the way it is. And with those two rules, you can pretty much derive anything you want. You can make circuits and compute things in ways you couldn't before.